Greetings, dear W124 friends, fans and owners. This is Ivica speaking. And at the very beginning, I would like to ask you kindly to subscribe to the channel. Our today's video is going to be the final video on the fuel distributor. Hi guys, I would like to begin this video with an apology. Look. And it is about this barrel. As I, in my first video, disassembled the fuel distributor, these holders were upside down. And that's how they should be mounted. So not like this. As I mounted them like this. This one. And this one, they should be upside down. So you see this hole, this like a hole, that hole should be upwards, not downwards. And now I'm going to set them as they should be. So again, not like this, but like this. That's how the holders should be. Like that, with this curve upwards. Sorry again. Again, I'm going to make this correction off camera, the last one. So not like this downwards, but like this upwards. And you just put them, the holder will tell you how much it goes, and it won't go any further. Okay. See you in the next one, in the next segment. In this video, we are going to summarize everything and to draw the conclusion, to see whether we have to change this part, if we have to mess up with this part or not. Well, stay tuned. I hope now you had the opportunity to see how everything looks like inside and outside concerning the fuel distributor. I didn't want to use my fuel distributor on the car. I wanted to buy some old non-functional one and to show you how everything looks like. I did this because I didn't find any satisfactory explanation on the fuel distributor concerning the adjusting screws. How do you calibrate this unit anyway? Nowhere in these books concerning the fuel injection or on the internet, nothing. How do you calibrate the unit? I found some explanation that says that the fuel distributor should be reset, that the adjusting screws should be retightened each 200k kilometers. And it is something like this. Let me just read this to you. They say that these screws are very sensitive, like on the fuel pressure regulator. And it can come to the situation that they are not all tightened equally. So then they should not be touched, only in case they are loose equally.
What?
Wow. Now, as we went through both theory and praxis, it's time to see, do we have to panic about this part because it is up to 40 years old? And, well, the thing I could see and the thing I could conclude is definitely not. No. Those who want to open the fuel distributor, to disassemble it and reassemble, those are the people that do rebuilds. The people that rebuild stuff and they have rebuilt everything on their system and they want to clear the fuel distributor. Or because the rubber inside got stiff. As you know, as the rubber ages, it becomes stiff. But the rubber is the only thing that likes humidity. As long as it is wet in the fuel distributor, and as long as there is fuel in the fuel distributor, then there is no reason for panic. Be careful. I just want to say that you should be careful that live in the lands where you have ethanol in fuel, because ethanol destroys the diaphragm inside the fuel distributor. Now, if you haven't started your car for a year or longer, then you could have this issue with the distributor, but again, check at first if you have to disassemble it or not. And to get it rebuilt. If you live in the dry climate area where it's raining rare, then once a week start your car and drive it for some while, if your W124 is not your daily driver. If checked everything on the car that can be issue of a bad running engine and an increased fuel consumption, as for example, the injectors, the fuel pressure regulator, the oxygen sensor, the potentiometer, the coolant temperature sensor, etc. As well as if the sensor plate won't go up or it doesn't move anyhow and you can't build the pressure and your fuel accumulator is good, then consider checking the distributor and perform a series of tests that can show you if the distributor is bad or not. The first test will be the ideal differential pressure. You take your pressure gauge and you measure the pressure, both the raw pressure on the cold start valve and the working pressure at the lower chamber. And you then see if you have the ideal difference of 0.4 bar, then it is okay. If that test was good, then you can go to the second one. The second test would be to see if there are any leaks out of the distributor. How can we know if there are any leaks or not? At first, you disassemble the air filter housing and then you unscrew the metal hoses leading from the fuel distributor to the injectors. Then you have to take off the fuel pump relay and to make the fuel pump running constantly. If you don't know how to do this, I will post the link right above here. And watch the video. We're on the minute 5:50, 5 minutes and 50 seconds. There I explain how you can make the fuel pumper running constantly. The next thing would be to turn the ignition on. Then you observe your fuel distributor. You touch nothing. If there is no fuel coming out of the ports, then it is good. That means that your diaphragm is not ruptured. And it's good. The next test. The next one will be now to deflect the sensor plate a bit. And as you deflect it, the fuel must start rising up from the ports. That means that you want to test if you have a fuel flow or not. And how much? How much fuel? You deflect it and then you can see if the difference is not huge. It should not be huge. It will be a bit difference in the chambers, but it would be bad if that difference is drastic. As you perform that test, and if you have fuel flowing from your pressure lines, then that means that your fuel distributor is good. And the fuel is flowing to the cylinders. As you performed all these tests, then there is really no reason to panic. And then you should know that your fuel distributor is in a good shape. You have an equal amount of fuel flowing to the cylinders, your diaphragm is not ruptured, and you have no fuel leaks, and everything is just okay as it should be. So again, the main reason for messing up with the fuel distributor is either because you don't have equal amount of fuel flowing to the cylinders, or if the plunger is stuck. If disassembling the distributor, use the kit by your reference number. You know, in my previous part, I've posted the number of this rebuild kit. And use this. Don't buy Chinese stuff. Don't buy the universal one, because it's very important for the diaphragm to have holes the same size like on your lower chamber. They mustn't be wider, because you will have fuel leaks, as well as the O-rings. They must be the same size as those in the distributor. Those O-rings on the barrel and in the distributor itself. So be careful and buy the original kit only. Here, as you see. And make sure that the specialist does these work. Or if you decide to do that, be very careful. This is not a joke, as I've been saying that in my previous videos on this part. So there you have it. This is the fuel distributor. I've tried to demystify it as hard as I could. I think I've managed to demystify this part, to show you as close as possible how it looks like, what it does, how to do, what to do with it, what you shouldn't do with that, what you should be paying attention on. And here I would end my series on the fuel distributor. If you like this video, then please like it, share it, comment it, and if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, my dear, please tell them what they should do.
Please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified when we post new videos.
And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.
Hey, wait. Have a great day.